Here we go. Yep, we're on. We went to the shack this weekend and once again had a fantastic time. And just wonderful. It was beautiful. The drive up was incredible. Rust colors like you couldn't believe. I mean, just off the charts. We went duck hunting the first morning that we were there. We loaded up. We walked out. We're walking out to the blind, getting ready to go. Friends pulled up with us. It was great. The kids, when they're on the farm, they get very creative, and it's kind of fun to get these city suburban kids out in the wilderness doing these things. Just a great time, and I'm so thankful for the people that are there. And this is where the blab comes in. These people that we're with are reconciliatory people. And the book that I read by Phil Gaiman, I'm still on that theme. And if you've ever listened to my videos, you know that I stick with a theme. Phil Gaiman really captures there's reconciliation people, I think, and then there's not. And some are very overt, like they know. There's my wife. It's nice to get her away from home because that's her. And people don't really know her that way. I think when she gets away from her home, that kind of old school, not that it's bad, we love her for it, but that old school mothering instinct kind of becomes herself again. And so going to these places is great. And a lot of laughs. But again, reconciliation people. People that are searching for relationship, consistent relationship, good friendship, lots of fun, lots of laughs, getting out to the blind, the silence, the beauty from the blind, all of those things just kind of come together to be very unique and really neat. Now, there's and the thing that Phil Gaiman's book for me got to, and I'm sure they didn't mean for it to be like this. Phil Gaiman's book talks about how it surprises a reconciliation person. You can see it in her face there too. A reconciliation person assumes that everyone else is going to reconcile. And there they are having fun, getting out of the four-wheelers. And that's what makes them unique people. Now, they're also what surprises them is that people aren't, that they're just kind of shocked when they meet these people. And I've had it professionally and socially, just kind of in the bike crowd, where there are people, the reconciliation is not a goal. I'm going to get my point across. I'm right. I'm going to show you how I'm right. And I'm not interested really in reconciliation. That's not really on my radar. And the scariest group, which I've also ran into, yes, we did get a little riding in. The scariest group that and Heidi really liked mountain biking. I got to get her to the single track this week. That's my goal. Is the Christian who is kind of, and I'm one of these people, and I've got to watch it because we go into the world saying, we're reconciliation people, we're reconciliation people, and you better be. And this is something I got to do a lot of thinking on personally. Because the problem is, so many are not. There they are in the blind, checking out the blind. So many Christians are not record. They talk a good game. They're really, really good at talking the game. But when it comes right down to the practice of it, they're not very interested in that. There's cool cat Christians that are interested in coming across as we're the coolest thing going. There's just vindictive ones that want to tell you I'm right, you're wrong. Reconciliation is not just a great picture there. I love that one. Is not part of the equation. Great. Heidi didn't want to get off the bike. It's so fun. She went up and down the road and all over. And there's Owen's wood duck, and man, is that a classic? I mean, that the markings on it. Keith just said that is a mature wood duck, and then there's another one that they got right behind it. And there's the group, and it was really fun. But it makes me think that group and like our Connections Camping group, and there are pockets of reconciliation people where you could goof up big time in front of them and know that it's all going to be all right. That people will accept you, that you're still going to be cared for. And then there's people that would seriously dump you in a heartbeat. And even through your mistakes, a judgment would come out, and or whatever. And for Reconciliation people, that's an eye-opener. I got to work on that, though, that whole, because I've always been thrown by evangelicals. There's something about it. And that might be it, that they've signed almost a contract that says, I'm going to be a reconciliation person. And then, but maybe that's just being a human being. They're not. And that's just, and I'm part of that. I mean, I got to explore that deeper. Lift people up. Make that your thing today. And try and find those reconciliation people and hang on to them tight. Because, and you don't have to hang on to them tight. That's what makes them beautiful. They're always going to be there. Have a great day.